Think Tech Hawaii. Civil engagement lives here.
Aloha and bienvenido to Hispanic Hawaii. I'm Richard Concepcion. Today's guest is Luis Espinosa. He retired from the Army after 30 years of service. And today he's a professional actor and he's here to share with us his personal experience and also to motivate you how you can become an actor. Luis, bienvenido al programa. Gracias por estar con nosotros. Welcome.
Muchas gracias.
Bueno, Luis, let's start by telling me a little bit about yourself. Tell me about your military career. And also tell me about your transition from being in the military to the civilian life. Luis, dime un poco acerca de tu persona, de tu familia, de tus amigos. Háblame un poco de cerca de tu carrera militar y la transición que hiciste de militar a un actor profesional.
Muy bien. First of all, you know, I was born in Monterrey, Mexico. That's like the largest city in Mexico in the north. I grew up in Dallas, Texas. Okay. That was through my elementary, middle school, high school. Graduated there, and then from there I transitioned. I joined the military, right? Just as you mentioned, you know, I did 30 years in the military. I'm very proud of that. If I could have done 40, 50 years, I would have done all that, you know. But there's a limit to everything. So I did that. Along the way, I deployed like 7 combat deployment missions. You know, that was pretty tough, and there's a lot of learning I did with that, okay? My transition into civilian life from the military, it took some adjustment mainly because of my, the combat missions, you know. Just being in the Army is no problem, but the combat missions takes a toll on you. I've had good counselors, good training. So the transition was okay, it was good. Kind of seamless. Financially, that's a big question in a lot of people's mind. You know, how am I going to make it out in the world, especially in Hawaii? You know, how am I going to be able to pay my bills
and stay right here in Hawaii?
And stay in Hawaii. A lot of people, how did you do it? Well, I did 30 years, Richard. And the reason I mentioned 30 years is that allowed me 75% of my pension, base pay as my pension, which it's kind of nice, you know. It kind of helps me out a lot.
Kind of help you stay in Hawaii.
But I can stay in Hawaii, and I really don't have to like look for the job at McDonald's right away.
Yeah, know? That's true.
So anyway, that you know, disabilities throughout the Army, it's all financial stuff, and it kind of set a platform where I'm comfortable.
So what do you miss so much about the military?
The number one thing is my soldiers, you know, and even it's like losing your kids, you know. I get an emotional talking about that, you know, because they're not with me every day, you know. I was so coming out in formation and talking to my soldiers, like, you know, what's going on in their lives, you know. I wanted to hear their problems so I can help them. Now I find myself doing that through social media, you know. That's the only way.
A whole different game, right?
I can't go to the house anymore. They can't come to my house. So, you know, we get by. And once in a while I get a call. But they still ask me questions like if they were my kids, you know. And that's really hits me in the heart.
Well, that's good to know that you're still there for them. But I want to know what motivated you to become an actor and why. Quiero saber qué te motivó a convertirte en un actor profesional y por qué.
Well, first of all, I have to tell you that I didn't have ambitions to be an actor. That was not even in my focus. I have to thank a friend of mine. His name is Jeff Parker, you know. My life consisted of going to the gym. After the gym, you know, the Schofield Barracks, of course. You know, I don't have to pay any kind of membership. So after the gym, I would go and eat at the snack bar, at the food court there at Schofield Barracks. And one day he saw me sitting there like, man, you're not doing anything.
What are
man.
You doing with your life?
Yeah. what, are you working anywhere? I see you here a lot. So he told me, he gave me an opportunity. He's like, you know, I know one of the casting directors here on the island, and I can get you in Godzilla. Would you like to do Godzilla? I'm like, Jeff, I'm not an actor, man. What am I going to do in Godzilla? So anyway, he said, you're going to be an extra. Don't worry about it. Like, all right, if I'm going to stand in this long line, And they're going to tell me, no, thank you, bye-bye. I don't want no part of it. No, anyway, to make a long story short, he got me in. I did my extra work. I was a Filipino coal miner, and I did a great job breaking rocks.
Right? He brought the rock.
Yeah. And my son even got in the movie. He got both of us in there. So that was great. I was done with it. But, you know, I don't want to carry it all too long, but I got to mention this. Things you mentioned about into acting, I was on break, you know, because, you know, there's a lot of breaks, you know, there's
correct.
A long movie.
Yeah, it is.
So we were tired, breaking rocks, so I'm hanging out, and then I get a call from Hawaii Five-O, one of the casting associates,
casting
director and an associate called me. So I thought it was a joke, so they were asking me, would I like to come in and audition for Hawaii Five-O? I said, well, first of all, I'm not an actor. I'm going to tell you that up front. He's like, no, we like your look. You know, we pull your file. I was like, what file? You know, I didn't even know anything about this. So he's like, we pull your file, then you fit a certain character. So that kind of catapulted me forward into acting. You know, there's a lot more details to it, but that's what got me started in this industry.
Wow, that is good to know. But it takes a lot of work and dedication.
Yes. It was not as easy as that first thing. You know, it was not that easy.
Now, let me ask you, from your point of view, what is required to become an actor? Is there any requirement? ¿Cuáles son los requisitos para una persona que se convierta en un actor profesional como tú?
I have to tell you that In my personal opinion and my experiences, there's three things that it's like the cornerstones. I know there's supposed to be four, but there's three. I want to name, personally, pillars. The first one is you have got to find whatever method it is. Maybe elementary teacher taught you, your dad taught you, something like that about keeping your nerves in check, you know? Think about you're taking a test. You go in front of the promotion board in the Army, in the Marines, and whatever promotion board there is. You have to learn how to keep your nerves in check, okay? Once you keep your nerves in check, you've already checked out one of the most important things of acting, okay? If you don't control those nerves, you're never gonna score any type of opportunity for auditions. Okay, because you're the nervous type, and they don't want a nervous person in front of the camera. Unless it's a character like that.
It would show immediately.
Yeah, you're done.
Yeah.
They're going to cut. All right, the second thing is you need to find a technique to memorize lines. You know, it could be three words. It could be a paragraph. You know, it depends on what the director has for you. But you have to find your technique on learning and memorizing those lines, okay? The reason I mention that is because a lot of people say, well, I'm a, you know, like the newscasters, you know. I can be really in the teleprompter and be saying my lines. It's not about that. It's about the acting, okay? Once you learn how to memorize your lines, that's not in your mind anymore. Now you can concentrate on your facial features. You can concentrate on your mannerisms, how the character you're portraying. And the memorization about the about your script, your sides, your lines, whatever you want to call them, it's automatic. You know when to spit it out. Okay. The third one is you need to have a positive attitude. You need to portray someone that's confident. Okay. And that goes along with nervousness and all that. But you need to be there likable. Okay. Once you have those three things, in my opinion, that's worked for me. You're going to be successful.
Well, you did a good job. What about school? A lot of people recommend go to school and take classes. Do you think that is important as well?
I think it's important, but it depends on the individual. You know, and again, I'm, the reason that I am associating everything I'm saying of my experience, and I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to be honest with you, you know, I have not taken one single acting class, okay? I've been to a couple of workshops, you know, but that's only a couple of hours, you know, one day and all that. It kind of, you know, you get a feel of certain things in acting. My school, personally, is watching, and there's a couple of actors that I can name, Alex O'Glogan, McGarrett on Hawaii Five-O. He's been my teacher. He doesn't know it, but he's been my teacher.
You just watch how he do
it. Watch how he do it.
Trying to imitate.
Imitate, because in acting, it's all about the eyes. It's not about your wailing your arms and nothing about anything else. It's in the face and it's in the eyes. The acting's in the eyes. And the other one is Ed Norton. Edward Norton. He was the first one, but Alex O'Loughlin has been the main one that's been my teacher, okay? You know, if certain people respond better with instruction, with, you know, hands-on, or whatever it takes, it depends on the individual, but those have been my successful.
That's a great point. A lot of people don't realize that being an actor is a business. You got to promote yourself, and you got to work on your skill.
Yes.
Because when you get the opportunity to go to an audition, it all depends on what you're capable to do in
exactly.
the audition.
Exactly. Yeah.
Wow, that is so great, and thank you so much for the advice. I want to talk about your personal experience. Talk to me about your first audition. Talk to me when you got the opportunity to meet the casting director. I want to know. Talk to me about that.
I kind of smile, and it kind of brings joy to me because during that time, I got to tell you, I didn't know what I was doing, you know. And I made everyone know that I am not an actor, okay? I want them to know that. Because if I fall on my face, it's not my fault. I already told you guys, I'm not an actor. So I walk in there, and naturally, I have to credit the Army, right? The Army taught me about keeping my nerves in check, okay?
Have confidence.
And have confidence, you know. With combat missions, you know, you're leading soldiers, right? They can't see you get nervous, because then they're gonna be like, oh, if my sergeant, if my leader is nervous, are we gonna succeed here, you know? Are we gonna accomplish a mission? So anyway, I have to thank the Army, because in my first audition, I went in there and I looked at it as it's another mission, right? Not one nerve in my body that showed. The memorization part, you know, that came with schooling and all that, but it was not a problem with me. Now, mind you, I was learning that. I didn't know the things I needed to do to become a successful actor. So I learned my lines, I was calm, I went in there with a positive attitude, and I'm gonna tell you, you know, I don't know if you know this, but it was my first time walking right out of the streets into an audition, and I scored a principal part on season 4 of Hawaii 5-0, season premiere.
Premiere.
And I went to Sunset on the Beach. I was on the red carpet, man, straight out of the streets. And here's this guy. All of a sudden, I'm walking with Alex O'Loughlin and Daniel Day Kim and you know, waving at people. Like, you know, I'm thinking, like, what am I doing here, man?
You drink it, sure, right?
All of a sudden, from 0 to 100. So that was my, you know, my takeoff.
And then after you perform and you got that great experience and everything, like, it go up and down, and then you just kind of realize what just happened to you.
Yes.
What happened after that? ¿Qué pasó después que tuviste la oportunidad de ir y participar y trabajar en Hawaii Five-O? Después que la tormenta de estar tan excitado y contento de participar, todo se calmó. ¿Qué sentiste después de eso?
Lo que sentí es estaba orgulloso de lo que hice yo, you know. Estaba, you know, I wanted to pat myself on the back, man. I'm like, I did this.
¿Te dio más energía para seguir?
Sí, pero lo que me pasó es que yo pensaba que porque me dieron la oportunidad esa y you know, agarré el principal role and I'm here on TV, my first time, I'm thinking, you know, así va a ser mi carrera. I'm going to be successful with whatever I put my hand on, and that's not the case.
That's not the case. It takes a lot of work and a lot of dedication.
And a lot of dedication. So I just had to go back and rethink, you know.
That is true, Luis. So we are going to take a quick break.
Okay.
We're going to bring some special message for the community, and we're going to come back and continue to talk about the story. And thank you so much for sharing all the experience of
Very well.
Your acting career.
Yeah, my pleasure.
All right, we'll be right back.
Crazy world, so caught up in the confusion, nothing is making sense for me and you. We've got to give a little love, have a little hope, make this world a little better. Try a little more hard, and every more, let's do what we can.
This guy looked familiar. He calls himself the Ultra Fan, but that doesn't explain all this.
Why? Why?
He planned this party, plan the snacks. He even planned to coordinate colored shirts, but he didn't plan to have a good time.
Go, 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 go!
Now, you wouldn't do this in your own house, so don't do it in your team's house. Know your limits and plan ahead so that everyone can have a good time.
Welcome back to Spanish Hawaii. I'm here with Luis Espinosa, a professional actor. We're talking his story about his personal experience, and also he's given us some tips how we can become an actor just like him. So, Luis, let's talk about those different movies that you participate in or TV show. You have Camino, Hawaii Five-0, Snatch, Break, Underground, so many, Triple Frontier that you just finished working on that. Let's talk about each and every one of them and the role that you play. Vamos a hablar un poco de todas las películas y programas de televisión que tú has participado, como Hawaii Five-0, El Camino, Snatch, Prey, Underground, and Triple Frontier, que termina de trabajar en eso. Y háblame de tu experiencia en cada una y también el papel que participaste en esa. So let's bring Camino and let's talk about the Camino first.
Okay, Camino. There's a casting director that gave me a call and said, "Luis, you know, I want to offer you a role in a particular movie, you know." And that was straight out of doing the Hawaii Five-0. So anyway, it took a little while to finally, when I received that call, you know, you don't get any prior notice, you know. So they call me and then ask me would I like to go audition in front of the director, you know, not with her and not with her with a video camera. In front of the director, so I'm all for it. Let's do this. You know, that's the first time being in front of the director. So just to give you a little insight of that particular one, I auditioned at a picnic table over right next to the zoo in that little park area.
The park in Waikiki.
By that gazebo they have it there in the middle.
Right there.
Yeah. So it was right
no
there.
No, even
the
studio,
table.
Right?
No. I'm thinking like, wait a minute. You know, they gave me the directions. Like, okay, where's the building at? No, it was outside talking with him. So. It was the director and the producer. They were both sitting side by side, and I auditioned for that. It was about me and being a mean guy, okay?
And that was in South America, right?
It was in South America, yeah. So they had me say some really mean things and then kind of ad-lib, do it on my own, right? Matter of fact, he said, let's say that you're attacking my family and you're going to torture my kids one at a time. That's exactly what he said.
And then you say whatever you got to say. That he adjusts.
It was in my own words, you know.
Oh, your own words. Okay.
He said, "Make me hate you and make me be afraid of you." Okay, ready?
What was the reason for that?
He wanted to see what kind of a menacing person I could be.
Oh wow!
How mean I could be, and how you know? I mean, without saying any kind of bad words.
Well, you did well because you participated in the movie.
And I got it, and I got the part, so I was mean enough. So anyway, that was Camino.
Let's talk about the other one, the Underground.
Underground, okay. Underground, the director on that, same thing. It wasn't a casting director. The director, through information from friends, offered it to me to go and audition for that. They sent me the script, the sides. I did the memorization. The nervousness part, the confidence was all already there. I already had it.
What was the movie all about?
The movie is about controlling society. Society, like let's say a city, and controlling all of the people, and literally take them underground, like in a subway type environment, right?
Oh wow!
So I am the leader. I have to keep these people from reading about what's above ground. They don't need to know that. So anyway, it's me controlling society, keeping books away from them. Books is the worst thing, that's contraband down there because I'm controlling it.
So that was the title of Underground.
That's why it was Underground. Yeah.
Can we show the poster, the Underground? And this is the poster, and you are right there on the left-hand side.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
The young man in the middle, he was we both leads. He's the good guy.
The good guy.
And I'm controlling everyone in that picture.
And then from that, you went to the next movie, Snatch. Talk to me about Snatch.
Yeah, Snatch. You know, I've been a mean guy all this time, and all of a sudden now I'm going to be a taxi driver, okay? I didn't start off as a taxi driver. Now, as far as like in the acting world, I auditioned for four of the different parts. I didn't audition for a taxi driver, okay? When I was offered the part, they said, okay, so then we want to hire you as a taxi driver. I was like, okay, so when did that audition take place? You know, I'm trying to, you know, match one for one. No. They said, we're going to send you the sides. We need you to do your, not a mean actor, but a depressed actor.
A depressed driver.
Yeah. Actor, driver.
A famous actor, right?
Yeah,
Yeah.
So I have to be a depressed, because that's my life. I'm you know, down in Colombia, I'm a driving, this taxi driver. And I have to show that this is my life. I have nothing to give. But to just drive you from point A to point B.
Okay, let's see some picture of Snatch right here, you as a driver.
And those are my passengers, passenger. Amy Schumer and Goldie Hawn.
And that's you right
and
there.
And that is me right there.
All right, so let's move on to the next one,
Hawaii Five-O. Okay, so my teacher, Alice O'Glogan, you know, I've played a terrorist, you know, which was my first gig ever. Being a terrorist was natural to me because I had to handle weapons, you know. I did 30 years in the Army.
30 years in the Army.
I deployed seven times. I know how to handle
just
a weapon.
Just give me the weapon.
Yeah. Let me know, where do you want me to go? So the director said, Luis, go down the hallway, take care of this, go find, you know, whoever you're going to take care of. Did my part. Now, after that, you know, I played a Navy SEAL, also with weapon.
A weapon.
I played a sniper. You know, I was a sniper at the Blaisdell Arena. You know, so it was like a boxing match. I think it was season 6, episode 10. So, you know,
that's Hawaii Five-O.
Yeah, Hawaii Five-O.
Let's see if we can show that right here. Hawaii Five-O for you.
That's my idol there.
That's
my teacher.
Right? Yeah, that's the teacher.
He is my teacher.
Perfect. And then after that, you did Triple Frontier.
Yes.
And that's just finished. Talk to me without giving anything away. Háblame un poco de Triple Frontier, sin decir mucho que ha pasado, porque la película va a salir en el 2019.
Sí, cierto. Yo soy uno de los trabajadores, estoy encargado de la guardia. Okay, I am in charge of all the guards. I have to protect my number one guy, you know, in the movie. My number one guy is just, he's not a very likable person with the community, and I'm going to say maybe United States, the rest of the world, because he's well known. I'm his number one guy. So I do some pretty mean things, and I have to portray that what directors, what casting directors see in me. You know, if right now I'm smiling, but when I'm in front of the camera auditioning,
no change.
There's no, yeah. That's just a serious face.
So who is the cast member? Can you mention a few of those actors?
In the movie, yes. Yeah. The lead is Ben Affleck. He's the lead actor. You have Oscar Isaac, you know. He's the owner of BB-8 in the latest the Star Wars movie that came out. Pedro Pascal and Game of Thrones. Charlie Hunnam from, I think he rode a motorcycle in, what's the name of that show? It's very popular.
Game of Thrones?
Pedro Pascal's Game of Thrones. He's Sons of Anarchy. Yeah.
Oh, wow. So a lot of professional actors were in that movie, Triple Frontier.
Another one is Garrett Hunlund from Mudbound. Yeah. There's so many actors in this movie. It's very exciting.
Well, let's talk about one more. We got right here The Outbreak.
Yeah.
Tell me about The Outbreak.
Okay, Outbreak, I have to tell you that is not a motion picture. That is an interactive play.
Okay.
It's a Halloween-based interactive play. It comes out during the Halloween season, and you pay for your tickets, you come over there, and then I am the lead actor, and I take you through certain corridors. We always find a huge house, a mansion or something, and we're gonna scare
that.
We're gonna scare the
so
pants out of
often,
you.
How often you do that? Only once a year?
That's a once a year
thing. Okay. So you're gonna be on it this year?
I think we're gonna do a movie too about
okay,
that. So I'm looking forward to that.
All right, just let me know.
But I became a play actor too. So I had to learn that part of it because you have audiences.
You're doing a great job. You've done so many movies and TV show.
Well,
Let me ask you. What is the most difficult part? And what is the best part for being an actor? ¿Cuál es la parte más difícil de ser un actor y cuál la parte que más te gusta?
I really have to tell you that the most difficult part is, learning your lines. Learning your lines is really difficult. Getting to that point where you nail down your lines. The gratifying thing is, once you see yourself in the screen, man, once you see yourself on there, you're like, I did it, I did it. I don't know how I did it, but I'm there.
You did it.
So I'm enjoying myself.
Well, that is great. And what is your recommendation for future actors that want to do the things that are you doing? What do you recommend? What do you recommend to do, to start it? ¿Cuáles son las recomendaciones que tú le quieres dar a la audiencia, aquellos que a lo mejor quieran ser actor igual que tú?
Make sure that's has to be your passion, okay? You have to want to do it. It can't be something you do on the side because you're not going to succeed. You got to give 100%. Think about those three things that I mentioned before, okay? Nerves, learn your lines, and have a positive attitude, okay? You nail those three things, you're going to be successful. And only because you don't get called or you don't get selected for a certain audition for a certain part doesn't mean that you didn't do the best acting you could. All it means that maybe you didn't have the look that the director liked. There's been auditions where I won the audition, but my look wasn't what the director was looking for.
All right. So, what is your future plan? Any production is coming up?
There's plenty in Hawaii, and it's a very exciting place to be for acting because we're going to get overloaded with a lot of different productions with Hawaii 5-0, with Magnum PI. Now you got Midway, Battle of the Midway. You got Kong versus Godzilla coming around. And there's a lot more behind that.
I think Jumanji 2 is coming up too.
That's also coming, yeah. And then the pirate movie.
The Pirate of the Caribbean.
Caribbean. That's coming up. So it's being stacked up. If you're looking to become an actor, or if you're already kind of halfway there, you need to hurry up and you need to practice. Yeah, get those nerves down. Learn your lines and be positive, okay? You come into the audition room, go and shake the director's hand. Like if you know him already. Don't go in there intimidated like you don't want to see him. And I've seen actors that just, they lose it. Act like you've been there before, even if it's your first time.
Well, Luis, we have run out of time. We want to say thank you so much for coming to Hispanic Hawaii and giving us all these recommendations. And we want to say thank you for watching the Hispanic Hawaii. Don't forget that you can rewatch this program at thinktechhawaii.com and any other programs that is available. Gracias y hasta luego.